Okay, let's pick up a new polearm. Just gonna cost me a cool 750 million.
Hello.
Dun da da da. There we go. Now, on to the tempering. Well, I want to thank the YouTube community for pointing out that my Paragon board should change if I plan on using a two-handed sword for this build, and the build guide calls for a two-handed polearm. For some reason, I got a little bit wrapped up, I think, in the fact that I got a 2 GA item for, you know, 400 million or so. And I completely forgot that this whole build, revolves around having a polearm. So if you look at the Paragon board, for example, the Executioner glyph is all additional damage with polearms. So I've sort of set up everything to use polearm, and then I don't use a polearm. So I was able to do 135 pit with a sword that doesn't take advantage of that glyph. And now we're going to have to go through and temper this new polearm I just picked up and showcased the trading for that. And hopefully I don't brick it. So let's see if we have another polearm right here. Well, that's decent. So we'll drop that one there. And then we'll go to the rogue and we'll see if we can avoid bricking these two items. Well, actually, we'll drop them in the stash. Reorganize, just drop them in the bottom corner here. I really don't want to brick a nearly $1 billion item, so I'm going to use a couple of suggestions I got in the comments. One was, well, why don't you try, you know, tempering on one item and sort of burning off a couple of the misrolls, and then, you know, once you burn through a couple of the misrolls, try swapping in the real weapon that you care about. Now, that strategy shouldn't work. It really shouldn't if each time you temper an item, you know, the odds are the same and it's not like based off a cached value and the historical runs impact the future runs. But I don't know, maybe there's a chance. So let's go through that strategy. So where are we going here? Oh, my bad. Tempering. Okay. So we could start with this guy and see if we misroll the crit damage. And if we misroll a couple times, well, then we'll swap in the new one, the one we care about. Watch it just work the first time. Oh, my God, it worked the first time. I should have used the other weapon. No. Okay, so that one worked the first time. Oh, watch me brick this item now. Okay, maybe it just gets stuck, right? It'll just get stuck on rolling crit damage. Please, please, please. Do it again. Not marksman finesse. It did. It got stuck. I called it. Both of them exactly 130. I've seen this happen before. I've seen it with like marksman finesse or something like that. It just rolled four times in a row, the exact same thing. So now we have crit damage on both. This is excellent. So let's, on the first roll, oh my God, the luck is, RNG is on my side, right? Okay, let's leave. And now we need to roll flay, duration. Okay, so now we're back in the game. Stash. Grab these two items, which is the good one. The dual socketed one is the 2 GA one. So I guess we can try the same strategy, and we're gonna put the single one in. We're going to go weapon, bleed, augments, and we're going for that third flay duration one there. Oh my god, I hit max flay duration on the one I don't want. Okay. Okay, let's do the luck a second time here. Okay, let's roll another 70%. Just swapping the weapon out. Please, please, please. Give me flay duration. Give me flay duration 70. Give me that 70. That was beautiful. Oh no. Okay, so it didn't work this time. That's just unlucky that I put in the one I really didn't want too much first. Damn it. That's not good. Okay, two missed rolls. No, it didn't roll again. Exposed vulnerability. Oh no. Oh no, am I going to brick the really good one? Please, please, please. Come back to flay duration for me. No. So this is the point where, like, should I just, like, burn it on something else? How many do I have left? Oh my god, I'm getting close. Come on, don't brick. Don't brick. Please. No. No. This is going to be a brick. I just have a feeling it's not going well. I wasted it on that other one. So that strategy, that's it. It's bricked. $750 million gone, or gold gone. Oh, wow. And it rolled on this guy a perfect flay duration. So I basically lose 1,000 life by doing this because I didn't manage to roll correctly on one of them. So that's unfortunate, but that is what it is. So we're going to have to try running with this guy here. I just spent 20 minutes in the Hell Tides to farm some Angel's Breath. So now I can try to reroll vulnerable damage on this new polearm. So this is the one that I didn't brick. So that's when I bricked with Rupture Size and the two GAs. And this is the one I'm looking to reroll life on hit. So how many Angel's Breath did I get? So I got about 160 in 20 minutes. Not bad. So what you can do is go to helltides.com, look at the Helltide map, find at least 3 close proximity events, and then you can just bounce between each 3. And then by the time you get back to you know, your original starting point, the event will have reset itself. So you can just keep going around and around in each event. Sometimes they're only 30 seconds long if they're like Jar of Souls or something like that. But some of them are time-based, so you're stuck for a minute and a half. So about every minute, you're going to get at least 10 Angel's Breath. You just keep going around and around. So hopefully, and actually likely, I still will have to do more runs because the odds are to hit vulnerable damage are pretty low. So even though there aren't many stats here, there are weightings behind here, and it seems like vulnerable is low. So let's hope for the best. Come on, RNG. Yep. Oh my god. Is that a high roll too? I don't know. Let's see. That's the lowest roll. Well, still. Okay, so that makes me look like I'm wrong, that vulnerable damage is easy to get. But I have enough here, so I want to save some I gotta go to a different guy to craft some Holy Bolt elixirs because I don't have any, and I want to retry pit runs once I start using a polearm again. So I only temporarily swapped out for a 2GA sword, which was a mistake. So now, you know, I had good luck, so let's just run a few more of these and see if I can run a higher vulnerable than the lowest. Okay, no change. Crit damage would have been good for a bash barb. Crit damage. Vulnerable, is that, that's max. I stopped there. Okay, so there's something about this single GA item hitting the max flay, max vulnerable, and crit damage on the first temper on the rogue. So that, like, this item just, I got lucky on. Even the life is a high roll. So like everything is high, but the only unfortunate part is it's a single GA item. So now I think I want Wanton Rupture on this, so let's just put on Wanton. Where are you again? Wanton. Okay. And I want to go and hit up the training dummy and see. Let's move it down here. Okay, so wanton rupture. Now I need to figure out, without getting rid of this sword right yet, because I want to use it to test the flay damage against a single target to see how boss damage will change using a polearm, now that the executioner glyph will have an effect. So I need to find items that I have masterwork. Do I have any ones with stars here? Oh, like this guy here. So these were ones I used for my bash barb. So this, I should be able to refund the resources by salvaging this. Seems like such a good item. Yeah, like, oh, but I guess you're going. I don't want to have to farm pit anymore. I'm done farming pit for this season. What is this? Boots with movement speed and war cry. So why did I get rid of this one? I got rid of this one for some reason. I guess I wanted I still ended up with 5 war cry, and I had my new one has additional life. Oh, it's the evade charges. Yes, that's what it was all about. Okay, so I can get rid of these boots. I might save this amulet. Let's just see what happens here. So let's get rid of the boots, because they're basically a duplicate. Salvage the boots. I am using the 3 evade ones, yes, equipped.
That cannot be salvaged.
Why can it not be salvaged? Oh, because I have it favorited. Okay, well, let's just check my stats here. What do I have? I have... Okay, I have a lot because I was pushing pits, so I actually managed to get a lot of these mats. Wow, so actually I don't even need to salvage the high-end ones. I can go and find something in my stash just to get the mid-range ones, the ones that are masterworked up to 8. So let's see if I can find anything there. For example, these guys. Yeah, I can just get rid of all of these guys, because I'm not going to go back to a bash barb at this point. So let's just salvage some of those guys. Stats. Let's just hold that open while we do this. Okay. Damage to close. There, see this? We're definitely getting back all the materials that we need. And another one. And another one. Okay, so that should be enough materials to masterwork my new one up. This guy here, crit, flay, vulnerable. Blacksmith, masterworking. Okay, so now we have to take our time a little bit here, and we want to focus on getting our first crit to land somewhere that we wanted. So that's either, I'd say flay duration is way up there, vulnerable is way up there and something we want. I guess strength is okay too. I do not need a max life. I do not need a crit damage. So let's just see what we get. Nope. So I'm going to confirm. Let's go again. Okay, vulnerable's okay. But do I want to hit flay damage or flay duration first before I start pushing this? Flay duration is just so important. But vulnerable is good. Like this is vulnerable sort of makes up for the fact that I don't have GA on it. Okay, I have a lot of these, so let's just keep going on this, see what happens. Okay, double crit on vulnerable, all right. That basically makes it like a GA on vulnerable. And now the ideal case would be to get crit. Or not crit, flay duration on my final crit damage. You know what, it's not terrible. I think I'll keep it. I don't get the flageration out of this, which I think all the other ones I managed to get. Oh, I didn't get I got flay on this one, not on this one. Okay, so my single target damage will suffer by not having flay. So by hitting one crit, it went up to 115 on this guy. And my new one will have 101. So I lose like 10%. You know what? I think it's fine. So let's go back to the Oculist. Add another socket. Oh, no. Sorry. Gem guy. Add a socket. Pull out. Actually, one second. Do I have enough to craft? Craft. I do. Perfect. Because I do want to go and test out the damage now. So I'm going to put this pole arm in. I just want to make sure that the pole arm gets selected for both. Perfect. And now we are going to go to Kyovashad, I think it is. Test out the training dummy and see what sort of bleed damage we can get going on the sword, which wasn't designed for this build. And I was using for pit 135 and not being able to do pit 136. And we're going to see if the damage significantly jumps up, giving us an indication that we can actually take on pits higher than 135. And then that'll be the next step. Okay, so what do we have in our hands here? We are using... Okay, so let's put in the sword first. And just keep an eye on some of this damage here. Okay, so the bleeds are at what? I'm not going to do anything with war cries yet. What can we get up to? Just using flay. 170 million, 180, 190, 200. This is where flay duration counts, so... We will tap out here at some point. There we go. I think we're slowing down. 258, 260. Oh, we're dropping down now. Okay, 260, 267, oh, 270. All right, 290, and we're not going much higher. We might hit 300 here. There we go, 300. Okay, we're going to go for 320, no? Okay, so we got close to 320, but we didn't quite hit it. Oh, there's 320. 340. Okay, so let's say 350 million. Now we're starting to drop back down again. Okay, so we hit as high as 350. And it depends. Okay, somewhere around 350. Now let's just switch over. Actually, I should just right click. Okay, can you reset? Training dummy configuration. I don't know what's the default? Normal training dummy? Like, I'd like to do a boss training dummy, but I don't know. Boss training dummy. Again, not using berserking. So I'm not using my steel grasp. Just trying to see the base damage here that flay will do. On a single target. Alright, so we're already hitting 370, 380, 400. Seems like we're struggling around 450 to keep it up around 450. Seems to want to go down to 420, between 420 and 450. Okay. Now, just to make sure that there's nothing to do with the training dummy, we'll switch back to the sword. And we'll see if we can get back up to 450 with the sword. And I can almost guarantee we're not. So, no, 450 versus, what were we saying for the other one? Were we saying 350 or 320? So that would almost seem like we do like 25% more damage with the pole arm. Okay. Yeah. Somewhere around there. So let's switch back to the pole arm. And now let's try using steel grasp. Get berserking going. Get our war cry going. Now we're up to over 500,600 steel grasp again. War cry again. Now we're heading for 660 million bleed again. Warcry, steel grasp again. 720, 750, can we hit a billion? I don't think so. It is a compromise between wasting time doing the steel grasp and the warcry. See, now it's starting to drop. The average is dropping down. I think we can get close to 850. Yeah, 857, 8. Well, I guess because it's staggered. It was staggered for that second, so now we're hitting into the 900s. So we can get close to 900. That's great. Okay, so now I think the next step is to run a 136 pit and see if we can do better, if we can accomplish doing a 136 pit, because that would mean that the difference is all in basically not using the wrong weapon for a certain build. Okay, I'll see you then.